my cat ate, or at least chewed in two pieces, my lapel mic cord. He did it, and the three seconds it took for me to notice him doing it and shoo him off, and then by that point, like, the cord was, like, already ripped in two. So, man, he's intense. So I've decided that I'm going to copy my cat's playbook, and I'm going to change my motto to, I will pursue your deal with the same intensity that my cat had when he chewed apart my lapel mic cord. I think that's a motto we can all get behind. Today, we're going to talk about Thurston County in general, some of the history, some of the stats about it now, and one reason why I love it so much, and I'm sure lots of other people love it too. Michael T. Simmons, there's a school named after him. He led a group of pioneers who ended up founding Newmarket, which is now Tumwater, back in 1845, I believe, and then the area just blew up. In 1850, Olympia was founded. And things just exploded because the area had the falls, and the falls back in the day, you know, they needed, the falls provided a lot of power back in the day for sawmills and whatnot. Plus, having access to the sea through the sound was huge for shipping. I mean, the whole area was just densely forested, so everything was a lot easier just to move by boats. It's still seeing a lot of growth. A lot of exciting things have happened. Back in the 50s, it got I-5, you know, was made from, thinking, you know, California all the way up to the border of Canada, and that was a huge boost. And then it's, you know, since then it's had, in that time frame, we've also got the Evergreen State College has gone in, we've got St. Martin's has gone in, and the area has just seen a lot of growth, and it is still seeing a lot of growth. All right, I'm going to read you some census data from the 2018 census.
So, it has 286,419 people. It's got a pretty fast growth rate. It's about 13.5%. That's higher than the state average, which is 12.1%. It's got a high ratio of people over 65, slightly higher. So 17.3% of the population is comprised of people over 65, compared to the state average of 15.4. It also has a higher number of veterans. 10% of our population is composed of veterans. Woo, veteran! Versus 7.18% for the rest of the state. 63.9% of residents they own their own home, so that's something. The average home value is $255,500. So on top of that population growth, it also has a really booming economy.
It has, I'm going to post a chart here. Since 2011, it's just the economy has just been blowing up on jobs. It has actually, according to the Bureaus of Labor and Statistics, its economy, so the amount of jobs and the wages of those jobs, is when it comes to growing, it is growing at the 38th place out of 314 large counties in the country. It is 38th for how fast they're growing. And so, and it has been probably in the top like 70 for the last, you know, 5 years. That's out of 314 large counties. And the Thurston County Planning Commission projects that this is going to just keep going indefinitely. They say for the next 25 years, but that's because their projections, you know, stop at that point. So a little breakdown of to what that economy is composed of. So 26% of those are government jobs. And the five largest industries provide 58% of all the jobs total. And those are healthcare and social assistance, retail trade, accommodation and food services, like hotel and restaurants and stuff, and miscellaneous services. And then the other 15 industries account for the other 42% of jobs. So, and those government jobs, those are actual local government jobs. They're not soldiers or military. The top five growth fields, at least as they were counted back in the 2016 study, are government jobs. So those are continued. Those are projected to continue growing. Construction, once again, healthcare and social assistance. Retail trade and professional and scientific and technical services. All my sources will be in the description below, but one of them is going to be a link to a very detailed sheet about the growth of certain specific industries in Thurston County, and I would encourage you to check that out. So in 2013, about 70% of people who lived in Thurston County also worked in Thurston County. A large majority of people who lived in Thurston County but didn't work in Thurston County commuted to Pierce County. So that's JBLM, most likely. So basically, the vast majority of people who work here can also afford to live here. So that's cool. Now, consumer confidence has been growing since 2012, and I would say with good reason. Thurston County is one of 14 IPZs in the state of Washington. So an IPZ is an innovation partnership zone. It's basically an area that this Department of Commerce has said, all right, this little area in Washington State is going to be, we're going to really focus on this one industry and growing that area. IPZs have seen a lot of additional job growths in the past. Plus, they've seen a lot of patents, as a matter of fact, because there's legitimately a lot of innovation. So Thurston County just got branded an IPZ back in 2015 and 2016, and its IPZ is brewing beer and distilling. So that's like going to be our thing. It's going to be beer and alcohol. If you are driving in Tumwater at all, and you drive on Capitol past the valley and past the old brewery there, they got all that construction going up, and it's the brewery district, I believe. That's an IPZ at work right there. We do see a lot of our economy is influenced by JBLM being to the north, and so the Thurston County, you know, Economic Council recognizes that, but they say that a lot of JBLM soldiers also have intents of staying here after they get out of the military. So one thing about Thurston County is there's a lot of diversity within the county. You can be in downtown Olympia with its very Portlandy vibes, and then you can drive to Hawks Prairie, where there's a lot of, you know, giant, you know, retail centers around Cabela's and Costco. And then you can drive, you know, 30 minutes out and, you know, towards Yelm or Rainier, and it's an entire different setting and feel. And so there's a lot of diversity in the county, and I think that's pretty cool because, you know, depending on what your mood, you're never really 30 minutes away from, you know, from what you're feeling like being surrounded in. And I would say that for a county that isn't immensely huge, doesn't have a lot of traffic, isn't super congested, we have a lot to do. There's obviously stuff that's close by. You know, we got Mount St. Helens, we got Mount Rainier. The ocean is just like, you know, to the west, is just like an hour and a half away. We have the Capitol Forest and, the Olympic Peninsula. That's all close by. We have the Sound. We got skiing, and we got tons of lakes, and even in Thurston County, I mean, there's so much more than this little list here, but, you know, we got the Westfield Mall, which is a great and growing, commercial and entertainment area. We got downtown Olympia, we got the Olympia Waterfront, we got two awesome movie theaters in there, we got Cabela's, we got Boom Shaka, which is awesome, Hands-On Children's Museum, Olympic Flight Museum, we got Wolf Haven, that place is cool, Nisqually Nature Reserve, the place is gorgeous, Watershed Park, Tumwater Falls, the Chehalis Trail, we got Burford Park, easy access to kayaking and boating. I mean, you go to Tugboat Annie's, you can rent a kayak and just go out on the water right there. Or if you got your own kayak, just plop it in the water and go. You got Deschutes Falls Park, it's gorgeous, and so much more. I mean, there is so much to do in this county. There's so much natural beauty and so much culture. I really think it's a great county to live in. When it comes to schools, I think the Thurston County schools are actually really great too. So according to schooldigger.com, out of 205 school districts, Thurston County's rated, so Olympia School District is 21st, and Tumwater's is 31st, North Thurston's, which is Lacey basically, is 75th, Rochester is 108th, and Tenino is 120th. And Yelm, they didn't have a rating for Yelm for some reason. There's also quite a bit of diversity in the crime rate in Thurston County. According to neighborhoodscout.com, Olympia, according to that, the vast majority of Thurston County actually rates pretty relatively badly. I'm going to... Here's a picture you can see right here. So the crime index, the higher the better. So you want it to be higher. So Olympia and Yelm and even Lacey and Tumwater, Tenino, they're all not super, you know, there's a, you know, the relatively high crime rate. Rate of violent crime. So basically, you know, for every 1,000 people, how many, you know, can expect to be, you know, punched in the neck or whatever. Olympia says basically every 5 people are going to be the victims or at least somehow involved in some kind of a violent crime. Now, you know, obviously, a violent crime isn't necessarily like, you know, a murder or something like that. It could just be, you know, a dispute. Obviously, you'll take this with a grain of salt. Say, as someone who's, you know, lived here for years and years, and also reflective of the research I've done, the majority of the crimes aren't really, you know, once again, they're all kind of low-grade ones. So there might be a lot of occurrences, but the intensity's not super high. The Thurston County Sheriff's Department has a really great interactive map with what crimes have been noted over, you know, over the last week or last year. You can select your time frame, you can select what kind of crimes you're watching for, and you can see where they've happened. Use this if you're looking at a certain area. You can kind of see, you know, how is the crime rate in the area. There are definitely some spots that seem to have more occurrences, you know, of certain addresses even. The Olympia PD has a really great one. I'm going to post the link for both of these in the description below. So there you have it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate your time. Thurston County is it's pioneered, you know, over 170-ish years ago. It's seen a lot of growth and a lot of great things happen. And there is still tons of growth going on and more great things happening. I think it's a great place. I've loved living in it, and I think it's a spot that you would like living in too. And yeah, if you have any questions, feel free to please reach out to me. You can always visit my website, drewforyou.com. So hope you all have a great day, and remember,